This week on Maker Update, the slowest video player ever made, a 5-axis 3D printer, a flip digit clock, an NFC music player for kids, an internet-controlled drawbot, NeoPixel octocouplers, gesture-controlled LEDs, and the joys of gaffer tape. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome to another Maker Update. I hope you're all doing well. I'm feeling good, and I've got another fun show for you this week, so let's get started with the project of the week. Over on Medium, Bryan Boyer talks about his Raspberry Pi-based e-paper movie player. He calls it the VSMP, or Very Slow Movie Player. Instead of playing back a movie at 24 frames per second, his project plays back video at 24 frames per hour. For example, a 2-hour movie like 2001: A Space Odyssey would play out over 8,000 hours, almost an entire year. It's a crazy idea, but with the right movie, there's something kind of beautiful about it. Bryan's piece on Medium goes over some of the project's hurdles, his artistic intention, and an overview of how different makers and companies have put their unique spin on e-paper technology. If you'd like to give the project a shot, he links over to his GitHub repository with all the code you'd need. In news this week, I was excited to see this post on MakeZine about the development of a 5-axis 3D printer. Developed by Q5D Technologies, the printer's extruder sits at the end of a robot arm, allowing it to lay down filament at angles that would otherwise be impossible. It remains to be seen what the practical advantages are for this technology, but it's exciting to see new ideas being developed. More projects. Through the Tindy blog, I learned about Coyt Barringer's flip display clock. Any kind of flip display technology gets me every time, but this one looks and sounds just like I'd want it to. Coyt goes over every aspect of the design and shares every file and detail you'd need to make your own. As a shortcut, you can buy the pre-assembled board from him for $170. But my favorite practical bit in here is learning that you can score single 7-segment flip digits on eBay for around $11. I don't know how I'd drive it just yet, but I'm real tempted to pick one up just to play around with it. On GitHub, this children's MP3 player by Oxulo plays back songs based on RFID badges placed in its mouth. The project uses an Adafruit Feather M0 with a Music Maker Feather Wing to handle control and music storage. An amplifier breakout board and small speaker are used to get the sound out, and an NFC reader from Seed Studio reads the cards and signals the feather and brings joy to children. On Hackster.io, 8bits and a Byte shows off how they made an internet-controlled drawing robot that broadcasts its drawing in real time. The plotter is based on the Let's Robot platform typically used for little telepresence robots. Instead, they've got their stepper motors mounted to a wall, controlled by a Raspberry Pi, and an Adafruit DC motor hat. A Pi camera broadcasts the drawing while people control it over the Let's Robot website. Also on Hackster, Pedro52 shows how to trigger multiple relays using LED strip. By matching each LED with its own photo transistor, you can set the pin high or low on an inexpensive relay breakout board. What's useful about this technique is that because LED strip only needs one data pin, you can use a tiny board like a trinket to sequence dozens of relays. There's also a guide by Dan Ionescu on how to easily add gesture control to LED projects. The trick is this SparkFun gesture board with an Arduino library, and with it you can translate waving in different directions into triggers for different LED animations. Maybe I'm crazy, but how cool would it be to combine those last two projects and make a motion-controlled relay sequencer? I might do it just for a way to play around with the sounds of those snapping relays. I have just a few tips to share with you this week. I came across a site called Makercase.com. It's a dedicated web app for making laser-cut boxes or enclosures. It's free and has a useful amount of options. On Thingiverse, Andrew Aaskedall posted this design for a 3D-printed Braille alphabet. The design is a hybrid of an English alphabet with an overlay of Braille raised dots on top, matched to their corresponding letter or number. Could be a useful option for any printed sign project. OpenRender is an open source creative coding environment similar to processing, but with a few advanced features. It's free to download and play with. I'm still barely competent with processing, but if you're ready to branch out, this could be a good fit. And for my cool tool of the week, if I could pick one New Year's gift for you to give yourself the gift of gaffer tape. I've been using two different rolls from the Gaffer Power brand over the past year. It doesn't leave a sticky mess, it tears nicely in straight lines, and the matte backing is great for writing on. If I had to condo my tape collection, this would be the only stuff I'd keep. Maker Faires coming up. We've got Maker Faire Bangkok on the 19th and 20th, and then Nuremberg, Germany on the 26th. If one's near you, go check it out. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up or leave a comment. You can get on the Maker Update email list to get show notes sent out to you automatically every week with a few bonus projects thrown in. And I volunteered to do the show because it makes me happy, but it's my Patreon support that really keeps it running. So if this show does something for you, consider checking out that Patreon link and chipping in, all right? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.